Yes, we need a revolution, but a revolution of human perception, a revolution of human awareness from which everything else comes. As the Beatles said, but when you talk about destruction, don't you know you can count me out? What's the point? You're just playing the same game and calling it a different name. We don't need to hate this control system, because if we hate the control system, we become the control system. We're bigger than that. We don't bloody take what it's trying to do and love in its true sense. My goodness me, you try messing with that in terms of telling it what to think and do. But you don't have to hate, you just become what you hate. It eats you away, it's a cancer. What we need to do is realize what freedom is and realize who we are, and then we might have a chance of bringing this to an end. What they're terrified of is not protest, but in us coming together, no matter what race, no matter what religion or no religion, no matter what income bracket, and healing the fault lines, the manufactured fault lines of divide and rule. That's what they're terrified of, because they have to divide and rule us, because together it's a fly on an elephant's back that we're dealing with here. Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Part of that coming together is that someone else's injustice is our injustice. If we only think injustice is worth challenging when it's something that affects us, A, we are allowing that cancer of injustice to grow and grow and grow, and eventually it will knock on our door. As Pastor Nehemiah said, first they came for the Jews, and I was not a Jew, so I did nothing. Then they came for the communists. I was not a communist, so I did nothing. Then they came for the trade unionists. I was not a trade unionist. I did nothing. Then they came for me, and there was no one left to speak out for me. We need to stop complying and start defying by non-complying. There will be no change. We have to comply with our own enslavement, because the numbers mean we cannot be enslaved otherwise. Comply with our own enslavement. No, no, no. Supporting the non-compliance of others, of their enslavement. Yes, yes, yes. We need to come together. As George Orwell said, until they become conscious, they will never rebel. And until after they have rebelled, they cannot become conscious. Well, how about not rebelling? How about just not cooperating? Not cooperating. Okay, some guy in a suit, whoever it is, comes out of the White House, comes out of Downing Street. We've had a meeting, we've had a discussion. This is what we're going to do. This is what's going to happen. And if, when they said, this is what we're going to do, vast numbers of people said, we ain't doing it. No power. Our enslavement is our compliance with our enslavement. We need what I call the non-comply dance, the non-comply dance, compliance, where people dance to a different drum, dance to a different beat. No, no more do we comply out of fear of not complying with these dark suits and people. We stop complying, but we stop complying with a smile on our face and a heart that's open, not in anger, not in bitterness, but in steely, we are not having it. So we hold our vibration and don't get pulled into theirs. Awaken, remember who you are. We are all one. All one consciousness. Freedom is being yourself without permission. People think, oh, we're all one. Oh, we're all the same then. I'm oneness and I'm oneness and I'm oneness. That's not it. When you disconnect from oneness into the limitation of mind and senses, that's when you become, I'm not oneness, I'm not oneness, I'm not oneness. Oneness is what? It is the celebration that we're all expressions of all possibility. Celebrating spontaneity, celebrating creativity, celebrating uniqueness is to celebrate the oneness of everything, which is just all possibility under another name. It takes nothing to join the crowd. It takes everything to stand alone. Are we not more and more standing alone? Because there is a great awakening going on. The only way this world is going to change, this reality is going to change, is when there is a consciousness shift, an expansion of consciousness beyond time and space, beyond the bounds of time and space. And there is the gateway to that this system wants to shut. Open our minds and clear our minds of the clutter, the irrelevant clutter that the system wants us to take seriously. Breaking the spell, breaking the hypnotic trance, breaking the trance that these people put us in, and ignoring all this crap from bloody teachers and media and politicians and all the rest of them. Shut the fuck up, okay? I am infinite consciousness. I will decide my reality.